morning, everyone. Today we're going to do another mat yoga class that is going to focus on pausing and being present. So I hope that you'll enjoy it. We're out here this morning, early morning, hearing all of nature saying good morning to us. And I found a nice quote from Amy Hughes. She's a yoga blogger. So I thought I'd read it at the start of today's practice. She talks about setting an intention every time we come to the mat, an intention of what we want to focus on. So for today, she says, as we begin this practice, we will bring all of our intentions to this present moment. This allows us to tap into the true healing nature of yoga when we bring more presence and awareness to our breath and our movement. So let's try to do that today during our practice. Bring all of our attention to our breath and our movement, and we're going to realize how great a gift it is to our spirit when we practice presence. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to start with both feet flat on the ground, standing hips distance apart. And when you're outside doing your yoga practice, the ground is going to naturally be uneven under your feet. So it's a little bit more stability work, but it's also just a wonderful way to really feel connected to the earth beneath us. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's start to unwind through the shoulders. Let's start to breathe in all of the fresh air that surrounds us. And if you're in your home doing this yoga class along with me, just breathe in the fresh air all around you. Rolling the shoulders back, feeling the chest opening, feeling our posture naturally lifting, nice and tall from the toes all the way up through the crown of our head. And then we'll finally roll those shoulders back and down one more time. Standing tall, you're welcome to close your eyes here if you'd like. Breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. And if those passageways are not clear today, please just breathe as comfortably as you can. Focusing on the sound of our deep breathing and allowing all other thoughts to fade away. Bringing ourselves to this present moment, right here, right now. Now when we're ready, let's slowly open our eyes. Let's bring our right hand in front of our face so the palm is facing you. Let's take these middle three fingers and fold them downward. Using our thumb and our pinky finger, let's practice Anulom Vilom, alternate nostril breathing. So let's use the thumb to gently close the right nostril. And we're going to inhale up through the left nostril. Then use your pinky finger to close the left nostril, open up with the thumb, and exhale down. Inhaling up the right nostril. Close the right, open the left, exhale down. Inhale, close, exhale. Inhale. 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 Close and fully exhale. Relaxing the hands down by our sides, let's come all the way up to the top of our mat with our feet hips distance apart. Imagine you're standing on the outer edge of railroad tracks. Now let's take our right foot and step as far back as we can for warrior one, perhaps angling those right toes out on a slight diagonal to the left. And let's turn the hips to face forward. Starting off with a flowing warrior one. Let's inhale both arms overhead as we gently straighten the front leg, then exhale back to a bend in the knee. Starting off with flowing warrior one, we're going to start to warm up the body gently. Couple more times here. Now let's take that right foot and step back into warrior two. Find your firm foundation. Looking out over that left middle finger, let's inhale the arms overhead, gently straightening the front leg, then exhale to the bend in the knee. Few more. 4 times using Flowing Warrior 2. Now let's come back to Warrior 2, stepping all the way up to the top of the mat. Let's inhale both arms overhead, swan diving. Ooh, down to a forward fold. And on the inhale, let's lift to monkey with a nice flat back. On the exhale, we head down to forward fold. Little bend in the knees as we rise up tall. Swan diving down. Inhaling, lifting to monkey. Exhaling, forward fold, rise up, swan diving down. Inhale, lifting to monkey. Exhaling, forward fold, rise up. Couple more times, really bringing some good lubrication to the lower back. Also bringing some warmth and good heat to the body. Last time through. Now let's bring those arms all the way down. Again, from the top of the mat, feet are hips distance apart. Let's take the left foot back. Stepping as far back as is comfortable. Angle those toes slightly outward toward the left. Turn the hips to face forward. Let's inhale the arms overhead, gently straightening the front leg, then exhale to the bent knee. Flowing Warrior One. Two more breaths. Now let's leave the right foot where it is. Step on back with the left. Find your Warrior Two. Two more times. Stepping up to the top of the mat, let's use our swan dive practice. Inhaling, arms up, swan diving. Forward fold. And on the inhale, let's lift up to monkey. Head on down to forward fold. Swan diving down. One more time using this monkey flow. Now from here, let's swan dive down to forward fold, stepping all the way back for downward dog, reaching the heels as close to the ground as is comfortable, both hands flat on the ground. Let's start to pedal through the heels. stretching out those lower legs, getting some good lengthening through the spine. Now let's reach both heels back and down, holding the pose for 2 breaths. And let's gently lower the knees, stacking right up into an all fours posture. So find a comfortable position for those knees. Inhale, arching the back. Exhale, rounding through the spine. Now let's come back to a neutral position, looking down at the mat here. Let's inhale and extend one long arm in front of us and the opposite leg reaches out behind us. Then come on back to all fours as we exhale. This time, let's inhale, reach out with the other arm and the opposite leg, and exhale back to the ground. Inhale, stretching out. Exhale, back to the mat. Spinal balance flow. One more time on each side with this flowing movement. Now this time, let's reach out with one arm and the opposite leg, holding the pose, engaging the abdominals for balance help. Coming back to all fours, let's try it on the other side. Reach out as you inhale. Keep breathing as you hold the pose. Now we come back to all fours. Now let's kickstand out the left toes on the diagonal, point through your right toes, and lift up with the right arm, coming into kneeling side plank. Now you can keep your right foot down on the ground for stability help, or you might choose to lift that leg and flex the foot that's in the air. It's always up to you and what you're looking for today. Now let's switch to the other side, back to all fours. Kickstand out the right foot on the diagonal, point through the left toes, lift. Rotate back to all fours. Now let's use a little sunbird flow. So looking down at the ground, let's inhale. Starting with the right knee, on the exhale, bring that nose in toward the knee. On the inhale, press that right heel upward. Exhale, round the spine, nose to knee. Inhale, press the heel upward. Bringing in a little extra hip mobility work while still lubricating the spine today. One more time, nose to knee, and then press that heel upward. Now let's come over to the other side. So this time we'll use the left leg. Inhale first, engage your abdominals. Exhale the left knee toward the nose. Inhale, press that left heel upward. Two more times, nose to knee. Now let's come back to all fours. Reach the hips back into child pose here. Maybe we'll walk the hands over to the diagonal. Just choose one side and walk them over. Then we'll walk the hands back to the center and over to the other side. Then we'll walk the hands back to the center. Now let's curl our toes down to the ground. Press those heels back and down, coming back to our downward dog. Holding the pose for 3 breaths. Keeping the abdominal strong. On the next inhale, let's come forward to a high plank or kneeling plank. Lower down through chaturanga and lift to upward dog or cobra. Then curl the body back, downward dog. Moving up to our hands, rising tall as we inhale. And let's exhale into a strong chair pose. Inhaling arms overhead, swan diving, forward fold. Stepping back for downward dog. Inhaling forward to the plank of choice, lower with control, lift to upward dog or cobra, curl the body back, downward dog. Moving up to our hands, rising tall and exhaling into a chair pose. Swan diving down, stepping back for downward dog. Inhale, move into the plank of choice. Lower with control through chaturanga. Lift to cobra or upward dog. Then move the body back, downward dog. Moving up to our hands. Rise up and exhale to chair. Keep moving through your sun salutations, listening to the body at all times, feeling that wonderful heat building there. let's use two more sun salutations. Last time through. Now let's bring those arms down. Go ahead and take a drink if you have one with you. Definitely a good idea to stay hydrated during our practice. All right. Okay. So, let's take a moment here to catch our breath. Roll the shoulders back. Let's reach both arms down into mountain pose, reaching those arms down on the diagonal, palms forward. And as we stand tall in mountain, Tadasana pose, we might think to ourselves, I am the mountain. I am strong. I am grounded. I am secure. And today we remember that we are fully present, right here, right now. Now, let's open our eyes if you've had them closed. We're going to start off here with an airplane flow. So my arms continue to reach down on the diagonal. We engage our abdominals, inhaling tall. On the exhale, let's hinge forward. The chest is parallel to the ground, palms facing downward. Inhale, rise up, and let's lift the arms in front of us. Exhale, hinging forward. Inhale, rise up. Two more of these airplane flows. Inhaling those arms up. Let's reach them out to shoulder height. Take them all the way up. Swan diving to a forward fold. And on the inhale, let's lift the back to flat back for monkey. Exhale to forward fold. Rise up tall as you inhale. Swan diving down. Inhaling to monkey, exhale, forward fold, rise up. One more time using monkey flow. And then we'll bring those arms all the way back down. So now let's go ahead and pick up our strap. I just have it over to the side here whenever we need it. We're gonna fold that strap in half. It doesn't have to be perfect. 2 feet flat on the ground. Connecting ourselves to the earth. Let's lift those arms up to shoulder height, straight out in front of you. If you want, you can take those arms all the way up overhead for upholding heaven posture. relaxing through the shoulders. Relax them back and down. Think about drawing energy up from the ground beneath us, bringing it up through the soles of our feet, feeling it rise all the way up through the crown of our head and radiating all around us with good positive energy. Now let's lower those arms down. Go ahead and just toss your strap over to the side here. Now let's inhale both arms overhead. As we exhale, let's gently twist over to one side. And on the inhale, bring those arms back to the center. Exhale over to the other side. Let's inhale up. Exhale, twist. I like to call these snow angel twists. It's a nice gentle twist, but it still does a great job of getting lots of good fluids into all the nooks and crannies of the spine. Now we're engaging our abdominals. We're rising up to our own tallest height and enjoying these gentle twists. Couple more times. Now let's bring those arms all the way down, rolling our shoulders back. Let's reach both arms back for chest expansion pose, feeling that little arch in the back and that big opening for the chest. Breathing deeply. Now let's wrap our arms around a big tree trunk, rounding through the spine, engaging those abdominal muscles. Now let's open up. Let's come all the way out to the top of our mat here. So let's make sure both feet are flat on the ground, hips distance apart. Let's inhale the arms overhead, swan dive down to a forward fold. Let's step all the way back for downward dog. Reaching those heels as close to the ground as is comfortable for you. Engaging the abdominal muscles. Let's lift the left leg for three-legged dog. Let's bend that left knee, opening the left hip to the side. Take a breath. Now step that left foot all the way up to the hands and lower the right foot right where it is. And let's slowly, slowly rise up. Let's bring our arms into a goalpost form or cactus arms, looking straight ahead in Warrior One. Now when you're ready, let's pick up that right foot, gently stepping back into Warrior Two. Find your firm foundation here, looking out over the tip of the left middle finger for Warrior Two. Now let's turn that left palm up toward the sky. Reach forward to serve your friends, lengthening the spine. then tilt the upper body back. You can either look up to that high left hand or look straight past the front arm or straight ahead, whichever you like. Now let's come back to warrior two. Step all the way up to the top of the mat. Now let's take that right foot, excuse me, the left foot straight on back for warrior one. Find your firm footing. Turn your hips to face forward. So your head, shoulders, navel, hips, everything is facing forward in warrior one. And we get this nice front to back stretch for the hips. Now when you're ready, leave the right foot where it is. Gently pick up the left foot, step on back, reach those arms out long for warrior two, finding our focus at the tip of that right middle finger. Now let's turn that right palm up toward the sky. Gently reach forward to serve your friends, then tilt the upper body back. Reverse warrior. Remember, we still want to have that good bend in the front knee. Sometimes it wants to ease back, but let's try to keep that bend there as long as it's comfortable to do so. Now let's come back to warrior two. Relax those arms and step all the way up to the top of the mat. Shake those legs out a little bit. Now let's use our static side bend. So it's a long side bend. It feels great through the side body. Let's inhale the left arm up. Reach up as high as you possibly can, lengthening the spine, and then we bend gently. Two more breaths. Now on the inhale, use your trunk muscles here. Lift, 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 and then lower that arm down. Let's go ahead and lift the other arm up. Reach as high as you can, and then that nice deep side bend. Now on the inhale, lift, 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 lower that arm down. Let's bring both hands together at heart center, inhaling and engaging our abdominal muscles. And on the exhale, let's start to twist the trunk over to one side of our mat, trying to keep the hips still facing forward as best we can. Standing spinal twist. Gently, gently, let's come on back to the center. Let's try it on the other side. Inhale, engaging your abdominal muscles. On the exhale, twisting, twisting toward the other side of our mat. Gently, gently, let's come on back, relax those arms. Let's move up to the top of our mat here. With our feet hips distance apart, let's take our right foot just a short step back for a staggered stance. Let's rest the hands on the hips. Inhaling tall, let's straighten the legs as much as is comfortable. And on the exhale, we hinge forward from the hips, coming into pyramid. You're welcome to keep the hands on the hips or walk on down that front leg. Whatever feels most comfortable for you today. And we're just resting the hands on that front leg. We're not pressing down hard, so let's be mindful of that. Now on the next inhale, let's walk the body upright. Step the right foot forward. Bring your left foot a short step back. Let's inhale, straightening both legs. And on the exhale, lead with the chest into that hinge forward. Decide how far down you want to go into your pyramid. On the inhale, let's rise up tall. Go ahead and shake those legs out. Now I'm here today in front of one of my favorite trees in my yard, so I thought we would appropriately use tree pose here. So let's shift all of our balance over to one foot, point through the other toes, draw that foot in. Remember, you can keep the toes at ground level, or you could lift them up to the calf, or you could try to get high on that inner thigh if that's where you want to be for tree. I like to change it up, so wherever you want to be today, listen to the body, it'll tell you. Now look out into the distance. You can either look at my tree, or you can look out anywhere to a fixed point, wherever you are. Now when you're ready, let's relax those limbs, shake them out. Now let's shift over to the other foot here. Point through the opposite toes. Draw that foot in. Decide which level you want to use for your tree pose today. And it doesn't have to be the same for each side of the body. Maybe you need to change things up. That's okay. Engaging our abdominal muscles will help with the balance. Four more breaths. Now when you're ready, shake out those limbs. Let's move up to the top of the mat once again. Feet are hips distance apart. Let's inhale both arms overhead. Swan dive down gently to a forward fold, stepping all the way back. Downward dog, pressing the hips up toward the sky and the heels down toward the ground. Now let's inhale and pick up that left foot for three-legged dog. Bend the knee, open that left hip to the side, and then we're going to keep that knee bent and bring it up and rest it on the mat. So your left knee is just inside, or just, I guess, behind your left wrist. Let's lower the right knee and walk those toes back. This is pigeon pose. It's a good hip opener. So you can either take pigeon pose standing tall like this, or you could choose to fold over that front leg, folding the body over. And as we breathe deeply, we remind ourselves we are fully present. Now, if you're folded forward, let's walk ourselves back upright, curl the right toes down to the ground, pick up the body, and step all the way back again to downward dog, engaging the abdominal muscles. This time, let's lift the right leg for three-legged dog. Bend that right knee, open that right hip over to the side, and then take the whole right knee and rest it on your mat, just behind your right wrist, and walk those left toes back as far as they want to go. So you can choose to be lifted here or fold over that front leg. It's yogi's choice. Folding over will help you get a little deeper into that stretch. Now let's walk our hands back toward that front knee. Here, I like to just roll over onto that right hip, bring your other leg around, and have a seat on the mat. Now, let's go ahead and bend our knees so they're pointing up toward the sky. We're gonna work a little bit on our boat pose, which is a balance pose that's done on the ground here. There's lots of different levels, so I'm gonna offer different options, and you can just stay wherever it feels comfortable for you. So sitting tall, let's hold on behind our legs, behind the thighs, engage the abdominals and sit up tall. That's gonna be our first option. The second option is to lean back, lifting one foot at a time, and find your balance on the sitting bones. Those bony rods you can feel right underneath you. Now another option is to let go from behind the legs. That's another version of boat. You might lift the legs up to a tabletop level if that feels comfortable. And the last option would be to straighten these legs out, making the body into a V shape. So think about what you're looking for today. Think about where the body is challenged but also comfortable at the same time. Let's take five more breaths. When you're ready, come all the way back down to the mat. Now, from here, from our boat pose, we have two choices. We can either use a tabletop or incline plank. Both of them start with our hands, palms down on the ground, right behind, under the shoulders, so right behind the hips. Tabletop looks like this. You're just gonna lift up your bottom and make a table with your body. Inclined plank has straight legs and pointed toes. Same idea, lift up through the body. So whichever one of those you want to do, let's go ahead and choose one and come into the pose. more breaths. Now gently, gently come on back down to the ground. Let's go ahead and bring the soles of our feet together for a nice butterfly pose. Now you can slide your heels in as close to the groin as is comfortable for you. Let's roll the shoulders back, sitting up nice and tall. Let's use our upright butterfly for a handful of breaths. Now, you can stay right here in this upright butterfly, which is called Baddha Konasana A, or you can add a hinge for Baddha Konasana B, a hinging butterfly. Let's inhale, engage the abdominals first, then exhale, hinging carefully forward from the hips, as far forward as is comfortable for you. Feeling that opening for the hips and that stretch for the inner thighs get more intense the further that we go down into that hinge forward. Now when you're ready, gently, gently come back upright. Now let's scooch on up toward the top of the mat. I want you to make sure that if you're using a strap that it's beside you, because we're gonna lay it on down and we wanna be able to reach it. So when you're ready, hold on behind your thighs here. Gently, gently roll down one vertebrae at a time and let's bring the knees in toward the chest. When we use knees to chest and we hug those knees close, we're releasing the lower back, just making things feel more comfortable there. Now let's turn this into a happy baby pose. So keeping your knees bent, let's just lift those lower legs, lift them up toward the sky, and you're gonna use your peace fingers to hook on to your big toes. Now, if you're saying, Becky, I'm not able to reach my big toes today, that's okay. You can hold on above the knee, like on the upper thighs. You can hold on anywhere on the lower legs. Some people like to hang on to the outer edge of the feet or the inner edge. Those are options too. So let's widen the knees out a little wider than the hips. And let's think about keeping our tailbone low to the ground. And maybe we're gonna rock our happy baby. Side to side. This is a nice way to massage the back too, but we want to keep that tailbone low to the ground so we're never compromising the spine. Now let's bring ourselves back to the center, release your bind, keep the knees bent, and let's lower each foot down to the ground. Now with our palms down toward the mat, just beyond the hips, let's work on bridge pose. So let's gently peel up one vertebrae at a time, lifting our hips toward the sky, keeping the shoulder blades connected to the ground for bridge. Think about creating a diagonal line from your collarbone all the way up to your bent knees. Think about lifting your bottom out of the water for bridge. Now gently, gently reconnect one vertebrae at a time. Reach over for your strap. I want you to fold it in half and just rest it just right across the abdomen like you're wearing a belt there, okay? Walk your feet together. The knees are still bent. And let's open up into reclined butterfly. Another nice way to open up through the hips. You can rest here with your palms up toward the sky or the ceiling, wherever you are. Now, it's Yogi's choice here. You can either stay in reclined butterfly, or we can make a small change that will involve more of the upper body. And here's what that will look like. You can take your strap in your hands, reach your arms straight up to the sky, right overhead. And then take those arms, and if it's comfortable to do so, lower them gently all the way down to the ground or close to it, beyond your head. That turns our reclined butterfly into a modified fish pose. So we get a little more of a back bend here. We get a little more of a chest opener. We get some mobility work for the shoulders. But if anything is feeling uncomfortable, please come back to your reclined butterfly. Now when you're ready, take those arms back up right over you, take that strap over to the side, and let's bring the butterfly wings back upright. Let's take our left leg and extend it long to the ground so it's flat on the mat. Pick that right shin up so your shin is parallel to the sky or the ceiling, and cross that shin over your long left leg. And let's reach our arms out like scarecrow arms, being mindful to keep both shoulder blades firmly connected to the ground beneath us. If it's comfortable to do so, you might take your left hand and gently press on that left knee to get a little deeper into the stretch, but only if it feels good for you today. Now gently, gently come back to the center. Let's switch sides. The right leg is now flat on the ground. The left shin is parallel to the ceiling. We cross over for that supine spinal twist. We might use the right hand to guide the knee a little deeper into that twist. Now let's come all the way back to the center. Let's find Shavasana pose today. You might have both legs flat on the ground with the feet gently falling apart in relaxation, palms up to the sky in a receiving gesture. If that's not a comfortable position for you to lie down, feel free to bend the knees. Maybe come back to reclined butterfly if you like that better. Shavasana pose is corpse pose, where we are still and quiet and peaceful. And we try to lie here without a single thought on the mind as best we can. And we always go into Shavasana without any expectations. And if we do have any thoughts come into the mind, let's acknowledge them briefly and then let them float on by like a cloud in the sky. You're welcome to close your eyes if you feel comfortable doing so. So let's enjoy this time for mindful rest at the end of our physical practice. Let's begin to slowly awaken these bodies from this balancing, mindful rest. Let's start to bring a little movement into our fingers and our toes, gently waking them, preparing them to carry us out into the rest of our day, or if we're using this practice in the evening, just preparing ourselves to carry ourselves into bed. Let's start to breathe a little more deeply, filling all parts of this physical body with good nourishing oxygen, and feeling our hearts shining with gratitude. So grateful for the time that we've set aside for this practice. Grateful for just the small act of being present, which is such a huge spiritual gift to ourselves. And always grateful for this body and this breath that is carrying us everywhere we go. Now, if you're still lying down for Shavasana, let's take a moment to bend our knees, hugging them in closer to the chest. We might choose to rock the knees very gently, side to side, massaging the back in a gesture of self-care. And when you're ready, gently roll the entire body over to one side on the mat, each of us breathing in the many jewels of our practice and exhaling all of the warmth, kindness, encouragement, and love that we have for each other, for the world around us, and for ourselves. And for those still lying down, let's take a moment to gently rise up to an easy seated posture with our eyes still closed. I invite each one of us here today to bring the palms together at heart center. Let's gently rub those hands vigorously, warming the palms of our hands today. And let's use our warm hands to gently cover our closed eyes. Oh, and that good heat that we find radiating there. It's inviting our eyes to slowly open, and we bring our hands to rest upon our laps. Clear minds, kind words, compassionate hearts. Namaste.